trying freeze-dried candy. They sent me the wrong candies. Airheads, I think. Gummy nerds, but they were supposed to be Skittles.
Oh!
Happy with this mistake.
Wow.
Hi, choose.
Oh. Great.
Peach rings, OMG.
If Cheetos and Peach Rings had a baby. This is insane! Woo, so sweet. Out of all these, the nerds were my favorite. Not too sweet, foamy, airy. Oh, this one's it. So many more to go. Let's just get started. Peeps? I just can't imagine these being any different than they really are, so.
Oh.
This is exactly like the Lucky Charms marshmallows. I think I like it like this so much better. Cotton candy taffy. I don't like cotton candy flavored things. Ah, they look so cute though. Wait, this is really good. It's like when you squish cotton candy until it's hard and then it just melts in your mouth. Shut the front door. They're gummy bears. I mean, you can't really tell that it's a gummy bear. I think gummy bears should just stay gummy. Airhead bites? Looks like a jelly bean. Oh. This is called Bitto Honey. Never heard of these before. Oh, jackpot. I don't know what you look like in your real form, but you are delicious. This is a 10 out of 10 for me. Oh my gosh, I still have more to go through. Stay tuned for part 3. It's got a water bottle. Part 3, let's go. Sweet tart minis. I don't even remember what sweet tarts taste like. That's really sweet. Toffee taffy. Oh no. I don't think I have high hopes for this one. Like airy foam butter. Oh my god, Jolly Ranchers! Blue Jolly Ranchers reign supreme. If you know, you know. It's exactly how I thought it would be. I love it! That was watermelon. Mm. Ooh, tropical Skittles. I know these ones are gonna be good because the berry Skittles, I already finished the bag. Oh, it's everything you want and more. I'm gonna eat the whole bag. Red licorice taffy. Not bad. This tastes like the giant tub of red licorice you would get from Costco. Childhood unlocked. Last but not least, Charleston Chews. Never heard of them. These are kind of delicious. The crunchy marshmallow and chocolate. I like it. Oh yeah, I could finish this bag, no problem. That's it for my freeze-dried candy haul.
The wait is over, they're done! So far, I'd have to say this is one of my favorite batches yet. Basically, everything worked except for one item. Let's test them out, starting with the giant spiders. They're basically the size of my face. I was actually super impressed with these guys. They're super crunchy, no chewiness, and a nice fruity flavor to them. Next up are the sour volcanoes. Although they're pretty hard, the flavor makes up for it. Plus, I feel like the freeze dryer made them more sour. They're not very sour to begin with, but they're very good freeze dried. I enjoyed them. Up next are the giant jelly-filled strawberries. I had really high hopes for these guys, but although the crunch was fantastic, I found that the flavor was pretty basic. Next up are the giant gummy dolphins. They looked a little diseased, but the flavor was outstanding. I really enjoyed the crunch, and I was happy that it wasn't chewy still. Flavor is great. Next up are the petite twists. Never expected them to come out looking like a brain, but the flavor was really good. I'm not sure if I'll add these to the site though. We're gonna have to test to see how fragile they are after packaged. Next up are the freeze-dried sour mallows. They were a little more dense than I expected them to be, but the flavor overall turned out pretty fantastic. Plus, the tartness to them made it even better. And now for the loser of this batch. The hot gummy bears didn't work at all. They were still chewy.
I was sent a boatload of freeze-dried candy. Caramel M&Ms exploded out of its shell. Lightest, airiest, crispiest M&M ever. 10 out of 10. Gummy worms, large and puffy. Fruity, light, and airy. 10 out of 10. I don't give many 10 out of 10s in a row, but these are just that good. Giant peach ring? I have not had a peach ring in a while. Another 10 out of 10. Nerd gummy clusters. Oh my gosh. I love that one. Lighter than a potato chip. So amazing. 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10.
It's the moment we've all been waiting for. They're done. And best of all, it seems like all of them worked. Everything has changed so much. The Nerds rope looked like little art pieces. Now let's taste test them all. Starting with what I'm most excited for, Nerds ropes. They honestly look like little headpieces and like artwork. It's awesome. They honestly came out really pretty and super crunchy. The flavor is exactly like a Nerd gummy cluster freeze dried. Now the Nerd candy corn. The flavor of the crunch was really good, but over half of them didn't come out. Now Starburst Airs. These guys had a fantastic flavor. A little crunchier than I expected though, but really good. The Freddo was my absolute favorite though. I would never be able to ship these because they're super fragile, but they're freaking delicious. I'm gonna make these an in-store only option. Now our stuffed fruit roll-up. At first, I was a little unsure, but it came out to be crunchy perfection. And the flavors complemented each other amazingly. I would definitely eat these over and over again, hands down. And last, but definitely least, the pizzas. I was not a fan, still citrusy, meh. They're done and they all look perfect. I don't think a single thing on this tray failed. I'm super impressed and super happy. Let's get the taste testing. Up first, we have the Krabby Patties. As I suspected, I am not gonna put that whole thing in my mouth. So one by one it is. I was super impressed with how each and every one of these turned out so differently. The bun layers for some reason came out hollow, while the middle layers for some reason came out solid and fluffy. And I mean like really fluffy, as you can see here. It honestly almost had like a cotton candy density to it. Either way though, it was still really good. Up next, we have the Fruit Loop Gummies. These guys came out fabulous. I essentially turned them into large, regular Fruit Loops, but either way, they were so good. They get a total 10 out of 10, and yeah, they're gonna be on the website. Next up, the Canadian Macintosh. The flavor of this was as amazing as I suspected it would be. Plus, it was super light and airy. Another total 10 out of 10 for this guy. Canadian candy for the win. Up next, we have the Giant Sweet Tarts. These guys came out really weird looking. They almost look like they have like a strange disease. I'm not really quite sure what the white stuff is, but either way, they were tarty and delicious. Up next, we have another sour goodie, the Crybabies, which also are Canadian. The flavor of these guys was super delicious and it had a really nice sour punch to it. I honestly wasn't really sure how they would turn out. They didn't turn out like a Skittle, but either way, they were still really good. They were airy, crunchy, a total 10 out of 10. Now, let's move on to the upcoming mix. We're working on a reptile mix, and the first one up is the Gecko. Honestly, was not a fan of the flavor of this guy. It's citrusy, and we all know I hate citrus. However, I was a big fan of the Alligator. It was super crunchy, and it had a really nice fruity flavor to it. Plus, best of all, it actually worked all the way through. Since it's a large gummy, you never know if it will work. Next up, we have the Snakes, which turned out kind of weird looking. But next to the Fruit Loops, these guys were my favorite. The flavor and the texture were another 10 out of 10. And last but not least, we have the Japanese Milky Candies as reptile eggs. They turned out absolutely perfect, as I expected them to be. Plus, the flavor was super creamy and delicious. It's my favorite time of the day, guys. Freeze-dried experiment time. A lot of you guys have been asking me to freeze-dry the Planet Gummy, so let's try it. Since these guys are super, super soft, I'm expecting that they're gonna puff up really big and probably get stuck in my machine. But I guess we're gonna find out together, aren't we? Now we're moving on to one I'm a little terrified of, the Giant Jalapeno Gummy. These guys are hot, so I'm not really looking forward to taste testing this one. Now on to the Sour Pickle. Ever since freeze-drying the pickle taffy, you guys have been asking me if pickles freeze-dry, and I don't really know, so let's find out. Moving on to a favorite of mine, Red Lobsters. The flavor of these guys is out of this world, so I have to assume freeze-drying them will only make them better. And onto something new, these gummy bombs. We recently got these guys in, they're super soft and they have a nice strawberry flavor. Because they're soft, I assume they're gonna work, and I really hope they puff up big. Next up, we have a Japanese treat. These are sour turtle gummies. They're not actually sour though, which is a disappointment. The texture also reminds me of Sour Patch Kids, and Sour Patch Kids don't freeze dry. Now, onto another low sugar option. I have been really trying to find you guys some low sugar options because I know a lot of you guys who are diabetic are looking for some freeze dry goodies. And last but not least, Tubble Gum. Ever since I posted my video yesterday, you guys have been asking me, does it freeze dry? Personally, I don't think it will. Gum doesn't seem to freeze dry, but we'll find out. I'll be honest though, putting these on the tray was a total pain in the butt. So freaking sticky. Even if it worked, I would not make this. All right, friends, we have a really weird tray put together today, but like for part two to see how they turn out. It's freeze-dried experiment time again. And today we're doing a beast of a freeze-dried experiment. We're gonna test out and see if this 3-foot long gummy worm freeze-dries. Since this guy's so large, I'm trying to give him as much space as possible when I put him on the tray. Plus, to make things more interesting, I'm gonna make him sour. I doused this guy in Warhead Super Sour Drops and a sprinkle of sour powder. Now, I know that I said the Nerds Rope in the last video was my last experiment, but I lied. Apparently, when James told me to wrap the fruit roll-up with the Nerds Rope, I misunderstood. This is how he expected me to wrap it, but I wrapped it completely differently. And again, I wanted to add a little sour punch to this guy. So on goes the same sour mixture as before. I have high hopes this time, guys. In the end, this whole tray became a sour tray. So on to the sour Skittles. Since I didn't find these guys sour enough, I gave these guys a little spritz as well with Warhead Sour Spray. And after doing so, I of course, again, used the sour powder. Up next, we're gonna show Warheads again, because a lot of you guys in my videos have been asking me what Warheads do. I have done a video on these guys before, but this time I'm gonna add an extra sour punch to them. And up next, I'm gonna make the psychedelic mice also sour. We know that these guys work, but will they work if they're sour? I really hope so. Honestly, that would make them even better. And now onto the weirdest part of this whole experiment. These chili gummies are a little spicy, so I thought, how fun would it be to have a sour spicy mix? I don't know. Like for part two, guys.
Trying freeze-dried candy with my Fiank. Jolly Ranchers.
Mmm.
Sour gummy worms. Skittles.
Mmm.
Sour Skittles.
Mmm.
Starburst.
Mmm.
M&M's.
Whoa.
Bussin'. Airheads. Hi Chew. bussin', bussin', bussin'.
Please like and subscribe.